The chemical composition of bone is divided between organic and inorganic. The organic composition of bone consists of the cells, which are the living things, and what the cells secrete. So therefore, the organic portion of bone are the four different types of bone cells that we went over: the osteogenic cells, osteoblasts, osteocytes, and osteoclasts. We discussed osteoblasts in that they secrete the bone matrix. Osteoblasts build bone. What they secrete is called osteoid. That is another organic component of bone. An osteoid is a gel-like substance. It's not hard like you would think, as the matrix of bone is. Osteoid is just ground substance and collagen fibers for strength. But we need something else in order to make bone a solid structure, not just the organic portion of the composition. The inorganic composition of bone we must take in from the outside. Those are mineral salts, or hydroxyapatites. Mineral salts are calcium and phosphate crystals. When they join with the osteoid, we form a hard substance that's resistant to compression. The rest of this video, we're going to deal with forming the skeleton, because recall, in the embryo, the skeleton is just hyaline cartilage. That hyaline cartilage gradually becomes bone. We call this osteogenesis, or we can say ossification, and that's bone tissue formation. So in the embryo, at about 2 months, that's where the ossification begins, and bone starts to develop and bone starts to grow, and it will grow from that point, second month in the embryo, until late adolescence or early adulthood. At that point, bone stops growing. However, bone continues to remodel and repair throughout your entire life. There are two types of ossification, intramembranous and endochondral. We're going to go through both types just briefly, and I'm going to point out the most important points. However, it's good for you to read through and understand the entire process. First process, called intramembranous ossification, that type of ossification, which we'll explain, forms flat bones of the cranium and clavicles. That's it. So just think of your cranial bones that encase your brain, and your collarbones, which are your clavicles. Those are the only bones that take this route, intramembranous ossification. All the other bones that make up your skeleton, all of them except your cranium and your clavicle bones, will go through endochondral ossification. That's where we use our hyaline cartilage skeleton and develop it into a bone skeleton. So let's go through intramembranous ossification. So in intramembranous ossification, the most important structures are the mesenchymal cells. These are stem cells. Stem cells can become any type of connective tissue cells, and in the right environment, these mesenchyme cells become osteoblasts. And we know what osteoblasts do. They start to build bone by secreting osteoid. And you can read through this, but you can see as osteoid is secreted, we get more osteoblasts differentiating, producing more bone. Some osteoblasts get trapped in their own osteoid, so there's our lacuna with our osteocyte now inside of it. Blood vessels start to infiltrate, and you get to see this spongy bone starting to form. Our periosteum is starting to form with more mesenchyme cells. Then bone starts to layer. We start to get lamellar bone, and that would be intramembranous ossification. With endochondral ossification, these are most of the bones in our skeleton. We'll go through this process. Not the clavicles, not the flat bones, but all other bones. We start with a hyaline cartilage skeleton and perform ossification to develop a bone skeleton. So here we can see a hyaline cartilage bone in the embryo. And In the perichondrium, which is the membrane around cartilage, we have chondroblasts, which will become osteoblasts. And we know what osteoblasts do. They secrete bone matrix, and you can see the bone forming like a collar around the diaphysis. And then we start to get this ossification center as cartilage breaks down. So the important point to know here is where ossification begins in endochondral ossification. So where is the primary ossification center? Right there in the diaphysis. And as you go through this, we can see the cartilage starting to break down in that diaphysis, and it will eventually get, I'm trying to flip the slide here, eventually start getting replaced by bone. So there's your primary ossification center. And as we move through these slides, we see eventually the epiphyses begin to perform ossification, and that would be your secondary ossification center, happens in each epiphysis. Now what you're left with, this is what we're left with in endochondral ossification. Our primary ossification center, the diaphysis, we're left with compact bone on the edges with a medullary cavity in the interior. Our secondary ossification centers, the epiphyses, we have our compact bone on the edges with spongy bone in the interior. Recall that this bone was once all hyaline cartilage. What's left over of hyaline cartilage is articular cartilage, which is at the ends of long bones, and the epiphyseal plate, which is a growth plate in children. This growth plate will seal into bone once the child or adolescent stops growing, which is then called the epiphyseal line.